got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yeah, the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come on, call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes while you walk your pugs. In a time you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go? Where am I alone? Not on a phone. Where am I on my own?
They don't know my name.
Still got a reflux, eyes drip out from the sockets of a teacup. Drink up inside, look when they peep us. Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge don't sink in? Life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Minute made, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every wave, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. They don't know my name.
Football League on EA Sports. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Washington football team and the Houston Texans. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Two teams here, each off to 1-0 starts as this one is underway on EA Sports. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. The Texans offense going to go to work, and it is Deshaun Watson at quarterback.
Might have won back-to-back Heisman trophies if the ballot had come after the national championship games that he and Clemson played against Alabama. But when you watch him on the field, you realize why coordinators and head coaches want to bend their offense to his talents, because when he's...
Set. Third and two, Watson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And he is going to have a Texans first down. It's a gain of six that time on third and two.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. Here's Madison running on first down. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40.
Alexander Madison.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Running down.
Out of the gun, Watson. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Will Disley, the intended receiver. And now it's third down.
Brings up third down and 8 yards.
A shotgun snap for Watson. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Call that a 44-yard punt, 5 on the return. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. So out comes the Washington offense as they get their first shot. And a look here at their go-to guy under center. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
And what I'm looking for from him today, the things every quarterback is looking to do. Lead his team to a victory. Doesn't matter whether he's throwing it, running it, handing it off. However he has to do it, as well as exhibiting some leadership, that's what he's trying to accomplish.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Back to throw here. And with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
Throw left side complete. It's Pearson. Only 2 yards, and it'll be a punt on their opening possession.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return, and the Texans will take over with a first and 10. So now we get set to see Houston for their second drive of the ball game, and they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. You took the words right out of my mouth.
Down and 10.
On second down, this is Madison. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line.
Alexander Madison.
It goes as a loss of 6. And now third down.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the gun, here's Watson. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete.
Watson's pass.
He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
Well, the good thing about covering any game I do with you is I know that there's no problem with rhythm. Now, what we're watching offensively, a little bit of a problem there.
Yeah, punt on the first drive, looking at another one here. Just a little slow. And, you know, they were talking about a fast start, but that hasn't been the case.
Yeah, and let's face it. Any team we cover always talks about a
That's
fast
true.
Start.
That's true.
But it's not necessarily going to happen just because they say so. And whether it's the script, whether it's, you know, just what they're going through, whether they're seeing different defenses, they're going to have to figure it out as this game moves on.
A 41-yard punt there with no return. Now Washington going to retake the field for drive number two. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Up past the 25 to the 26, a gain of five.
He was brought down at the 26. A gain of five brings up second.
Second and five. Sliding out of the... And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack.
Third and seventh.
Texans have an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. On first down, it's Ward. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line.
He's tackled at the 34-yard line. A 3-yard pickup.
Here's a second and seven.
Second and seven.
And a quick throw here, that's complete.
The pass.
That catch good for five. It's third down.
5 yards on the play. And it's third down.
Now back to throw. Finding his target, it's Ward. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Got what they needed there. The drive continues with a 9-yard pickup. We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
They'll run on first down. Ward. And he goes across midfield and down into Houston territory.
The running back again.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
Out of bounds, the offense.
You can almost see inside his face mask there, the look of relief. He coughed it up, but it goes out of bounds. They keep it.
Someone carrying around a lucky horseshoe, aren't they? If I were him, I'd go out and play the lottery after that one. A very fortunate man.
And they're operating in plus territory here. They're thinking points. Definitely don't want to lose the football at this juncture. Back to throw now on first down. Over the middle into traffic, and that's complete.
The pass.
That was the ninth play of the drive, and they pick up 9 yards with it.
A gain of nine.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He's trying to get it to Terry McLaurin, and it's third and short.
That's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
They tried to throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
Number 30,
a Third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. A much different second drive here, Charles. They go three and out the first time. This time they've been able to sustain something downfield.
And that's what often happens. You get the game started. You know, you have to get your footing underneath you. You have to get used to the flow of the game, the speed of the game. And sometimes that first drive is more of a probing drive. It appears they found something here in the second one.
First down, it's Ward, and taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
Another carry.
It'll go as a pickup of 14 and a Washington first down.
The first drive this unit had, they punted. This drive, much more polished, just looking crisper, aren't they, moving the ball?
Maybe the first drive was a little bit of a wake-up call. Probably a little bit angry that they had to punt the ball away the first time they had it. Got motivated, got to the sideline, said, okay, let's not let that happen here as we take over again.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Nothing doing there as the 13th play of the drive proves to be unlucky. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
It's third down.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they're going to drop him well shy of the first as he can only make it to the 11.
Well, the coverage was tight that time. They allowed the pass underneath to him, but they rallied to him pretty fast too, converged on him and got him down. That'll bring up fourth down.
So on fourth down, Ron Rivera sends out the field goal unit. And his kick is right there. It's good. And it's 3-0 Washington.
3, Texans nothing.
That drive just seemed to go for an eternity. I could kind of hear our sponsor saying, hey, we need to get our product pushed here. But then it ends in a field goal.
Yeah, about that. Not enough time for product placement, but plenty of time to get 3 points out of the deal. I know that the guys on defense, though, they wanted to get those products out there. They wanted to stop that drive, just weren't able to do so.
The Texans getting set here to take over again on offense.
And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From the 31, Watson looking left side. It's complete. He's got it. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 15 yards on the play, first down.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Running from the shotgun with Madison. And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line.
Alexander Madison.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
What? going on the ground with Madison. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. Hits his target, Hunter. And he is going to have a Texans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage. And that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area. So you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Watson on first down. Throw complete right side to Cooks.
Watson's pass.
Given 9 there on the first down completion. And we are keeping a close eye on his catches. A really close eye now because that's number 899 in his career. The next one will give him 900. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. They'll run with Madison. And he'll go down at the 28. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
1st and 10 at the 28-yard line.
On first down, it's Watson. And he is going to go down. They sack him on the final play of the first quarter. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24. Another try after the first down sack. Watson.
Watson's pass.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for 3rd down. They were in zone defensively, went with a crossing route. It's always interesting to watch that chess match.
Yeah, and I think safeties don't mind crossing routes against zone because eventually you're going to run into their territory. And that's when they lick their chops in order to get the big hit or a play on the ball.
Offensively, nice execution to find a hole, make the catch. Looking left sideline, it's complete. He had 3 catches last week. That one, his 3rd on this drive alone.
How about this throw right here? Had to throw it to the left sideline, and you know the timing's got to be correct on this one. Ball's got to be right where it needs to be, and it was. That's because he had great arm strength on that one, able to drive the football. Quarterbacks love it when they can show off their arms.
From the red zone now, Watson throwing into traffic there, and that's complete.
Watson's pass.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Watson, he'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down.
Time to give a little credit here. That was an excellent read by the guys on the defensive side of the ball.
Oh, you're crediting your defense.
Got to credit them on that one because they tried to fool them, right? Tried to trick them. Ran a screen, and they went to it and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
The Texans on 3rd down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Watson looks to throw again. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21. Chase Young, able to record his fifth sack of the season. And keep your eye on that man. Four sacks last week, one there here in the second quarter. He can be so disruptive.
So what was he doing in the first quarter? What was going on?
Took a nap.
I think he tried to lull him to sleep a little bit. Like, yeah, okay, maybe you've got me this week. No longer. And you know, with the four sacks last week, it's obvious he gets his in flurries.
Now Zane Gonzalez for the field goal try. From the right hash, it's a 38-yard attempt. Gonzalez's kick is good. And that will tie us at 3-3.
That ties the game at 3-3.
So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get three.
It's not like you're going negative on them.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
The Washington offense back out there. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal. And I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not odd, now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They're going to look to throw. And that's incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a fourth down situation.
I liked his effort there. He got it done on his own. But let's face it, he puts defenses in a really stressful spot when he takes off and runs because a lot of guys have coverage responsibilities.
Good job of rallying, though, because I thought when he first took off, he might pick up the first down. Here's Tressway now as he'll punt it away for the second time. So possession goes over here on the punt. And now out comes Houston. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas.
Yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting off field and giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
They'll wind up getting nine after tucking it and running, so it'll leave them with second and a yard.
And that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
That one, a first down pickup of eight.
Second and one, and people wanted to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Watson, and he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Throwing again is Watson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now after the play, it looks like there's a Texan here slow to get up. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Madison.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
They'll run it with Madison. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 15 yards on the play, first down. That time a little misdirection really seemed to fool the defense.
And think of it this way. From the time you're in high school, you're taught to watch film and pick up tendencies. Sometimes they can use those against you, though, when they break their own tendencies and hit you back the opposite direction, huh?
Now a give to Madison, and he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Sometimes in the run game, you can make the argument that quickness beats size. And how about the example right here?
29-yard line.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. They'll try the air now with Watson. Short throw to Disley. Stopped short of the 25. The second effort couldn't free him.
To Bill Disley. It's a gain of three.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
The Texans on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 9. To throw is Watson. He's going to go up top for the end zone. Strong coverage by Washington. And now fourth down.
Complete in the end zone.
Well, their first two drives only yielded 3 points. They might be thinking it's time to make something happen. Push the ball downfield and try and gain some points that way. Unfortunately, incomplete.
So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this from 43. Gonzalez's kick is good. And it's now 3-0 Texans.
Makes the score Texans 6, Washington 3.
So we're trading first half field goals. No breakthrough on the touchdown front. We've got a 6-3 game.
Yeah, and I know so many people look at a game through offensive eyes, right? They want to see how the game's played that way. You know how I'm going to view it, right? The defenses, to me, have responded well in this game. Like what I'm seeing from them, both of them hoping to keep it to field goals and not give up big touchdowns.
Now we get another look at Washington on offense. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
He pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards, second down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And they will score a pick 6 for the Texans TD.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. And a it's up and good to make the score 13-3. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. On the return, here's Hall. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
At their own 23-yard line.
A look at Washington as they come onto the field. They trail by 10, 13-3 as they come up on a first and 10. They'll run on first down. Moore. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 16 yards, a first down. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they had three tight ends in on that sack.
And these guys are punching really well. I use boxing analogies a lot. A lot of coaches have told me that when you line up to run the football, it's 10 fist fights along the line of scrimmage, right? You've got to win your share. These three tight ends, they almost always win their fist fights.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
A gain of a yard. Brings up.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete.
Complete to number 40.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 49-yard line.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
First down, Washington.
On first down. It's Ward, and he gets it down to the 32. It's a six-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Second and 4. He'll buy some time right, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Logan Wilson
able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. And there they bring pressure from the inside, and they get home.
Yeah, hard to block everyone, isn't it? And on this play, someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
Washington on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 4. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. They give him 16 yards there, and it's a Washington first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 7 yards, the pickup there.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up second.
Now we've got whistles here before the snap, and I believe this is going to be on Washington.
Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Third down. And
they'll look to throw again. Going to throw right side here. Complete. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive, it just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. That's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3, this is where the ball goes anymore.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. Now a first down throw, Watson. That's complete to Disley, the tight end. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. And he's going to go down. They sack him back at the 42. Montez Sweat in there to get him. It's a loss of 5.
You've caught plenty of games in your career. Do you believe in momentum, my man?
I do, and I think we're seeing it right here.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. The run that he's been on, how about that? 3 sacks in a game a week ago, and another one right here. Oh, he's feeling it in a big way.
Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. From the gun on third, Watson firing quickly here, and that's complete. Now the Texans will use one of their 2 remaining timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. From the 50, it's Watson. And a quick throw here, that's complete. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
It's a gain of 5.
Out of the gun, Watson. And this one caught by Hunter over the middle. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. And quite a bit of pizza in this box. It's a 53-yard attempt. And no, it doesn't get there. Hits the crossbar, bounces back out. He had it online, but it comes up about a rotation short. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Brandon, we'll get you back to you and Charles in a bit. But first, it's time for a trip around the NFL following an eventful opening weekend. Let's see what's happening in week 2. We'll begin up at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte, where it was the Panthers who were able to come away with the home victory. Teddy Bridgewater, 4 touchdown passes in the victory. From there, we head up to MetLife Stadium to check on the Jets, and they trail the visiting Lions in that one. The Lions trying to even their mark at 1-1 after dropping their opener a week ago. Finally, let's get down to Miami to see what's going on with the Dolphins. And they trail the visiting Chicago Bears. The Bears were losers in their opener, trying to get back on level footing as they lead on the road. In the game you're watching is Deshaun Watson, who was the star of the first half. His guys have the lead, as we'll hand it back over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. It's the Texans in front, and they're going to get the football first as we are back underway in the third quarter. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
And he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line.
The ball carrier.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
He'll drop to throw. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
Offensively, they like their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open. So it was tucking in run time, and he picks up a first down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Flush to his right. He's going to take off with it. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
The quarterback on the scramble. He's brought down at the 42-yard line. A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5.
And he slings one that's incomplete.
The pass.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. On the move to his left. He can run for it, and he will. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
On 3rd down, the defense decided to blitz. A very good job of recognizing it, stepping away from the pressure, and finding open space to scramble and pick up a first down.
So a 1st and 10 now in Houston territory at the 47. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and 5.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Not much there, maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
7th play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Ward, and he will be very close to a 1st down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down.
You know, we might start getting some props here in the booth. You know that one that says the D and then the fence that you put up next to it? How about that? They brought out the jumbo package and still couldn't move him off the line of scrimmage enough to pick up that 1st down.
Impressive. They were ready defensively for that jumbo set. This would have been a 54-yard boot had they tried a field goal, but they will not try a field goal. They're going for it. They'll try and run for it. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. 1st down on a pickup of 11. They only needed about 4 or 5 inches there, relied on the big guys up front, and got it done.
Yeah, this is the time to just go ahead and hit it straight ahead. No juking, right? No movement in the backfield. Take the ball and go. As I heard a coach tell a player a long time ago, save your dancing for the club, son. Just get up into that line of scrimmage.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. He'll look to throw. He's going to take off with it. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
It's second and 8.
On second down now, it's Ballard. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half. And that trend is continuing here.
Texans here on third down, putting an extra defender in the secondary. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 15-yard line. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defense side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Zone now. They'll look to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. 12 more yards for him there. It's a first down.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
Back to throw. Buying time to his left. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And the Texans scoop it. And the Texans are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
I know one thing, the team that had the ball and was driving, they're going to feel horrible. But the team that was on defense, I think we got to give them a little bit of credit, able to hang in there and force a key turnover.
In the red zone, though, had a chance to tie it and an opportunity missed. So here are the Texans to take over. They were winners last week over Tennessee, and they've got the lead here as well. They start this drive out first and 10. Going to begin the drive here with Madison. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
The loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. From the gun, here's Watson. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Third down and the 11.
A shotgun snap for Watson. He'll get this underneath to Madison. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They'll get 11, but still a little short. Fourth down. For that last pass, CD, he just added another notch to the old belt. What a career it's been. He's over 35,000 career passing yards now.
And when you say that number, over 35,000 yards, how many people have done that prior to him?
Right around 30.
Boy, that's a pretty good number. Now you're into a membership that means you've done a heck of a job in this league for a decent amount of time. You're recognized as one of the better players.
On is the punt team now as this one sent away. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. Just 34 yards on the punt there, no return. And Washington going to come back out here to take over offensively. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
8 yards on the pickup, brings up second and two.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's a first down on a gain of 10. They'll look to throw. Now he'll pull it down. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And down to the 28-yard line. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Well, to me, this leads to the question, do you admire the way he puts his body out there all the time, or do you think he should protect himself a little bit more?
Well, he's been on the ground several times with all those sacks that he's taken. So I don't know. I kind of admire him not sliding down there, don't you?
I'm with you on that one. The meter definitely leans towards admiration.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory as they've got it to the 28-yard line. And to give this time to the tailback. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
As a linebacker, you're taught to stay just slightly behind the ball carrier just in case he makes a cutback. But when you find the gap, shoot it. And he found it all right. Took it straight into the backfield and made the tackle for a loss.
Behind the chain, second and 12. Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2.
To number 80.
They got 29 yards that time.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Try and run for it on first and goal. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And Washington now an extra point away from tying this thing up. Attempt here still to come. It's right through, and we are now tied at 13. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. All square now at 13 all as he sends this one away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own.
Deshaun Watson and the Texans offense trot back out there. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. That catch good for only a couple.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Throwing again on second down. Watson, throw complete right side to Cooks. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Well, so much for that possession.
Yeah, I think he tried to do a little too much there, partner. He tried to keep it himself. End up getting buried in the backfield, and that brings up fourth down.
The Texans send the punter out as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. This is taken at the 23. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return, and out will come the offense as they take over. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. We've seen him be good so far. He's hoping to continue that trend here in quarter number three.
And typically when you see guys running it this well, they see the game in slow motion, don't they? They see the cuts happen, they see the blocks happen, they feel really good about their vision, and then they use their legs to find that open space.
And he's had some good help up front to boot. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That good for 21 yards on the catch.